This is the Red Sandalwood Museum, which is way out on line 106, Gaobidan, is it? Which I think is line 1. I came into Qingyanlu, took the bus. I don't know what stop that is. What's that? Is that a bus stop? It's a bus stop, I guess. 4 floors. Right?
5 floors.
Imitation throne room. Qianqing Palace, Forbidden City. Model of Heavenly Pavilion, Red Sandalwood. Model of 10,000 Spring Pavilion, Forbidden City, Red Sandalwood. Corner Tower, Forbidden City. Set of furniture with Mother of Pearl. Inlay, Red Sandalwood furniture of Qing. Main Hall, Qing style. Let's see. Third floor, architectural model of a residential compound with houses that surround a courtyard. Red Sandalwood. That's a Si He Huan. Si He Huan?
Si He Huan.
Publicity Hall. Display of logs and technique. Memorial Gateway of Long Chuan Temple at Wutai Mountain, Red Sandalwood. Screen set with ebony frame and red sandalwood inlaid carved with the painting 100 Horses. A set of screens carved with image of painting the festival Pure Brightness on the River, Red Sandalwood. Gilded architectural model of Hall of Prayer for Good Harvest in the Temple of Heaven in teakwood. A bar, reception room, second floor, screen and throne set decorated with inlaid sandalwood floral patterns, red sandalwood, screen and throne set, dragon pattern, ebony boxwood, video parlor, souvenir shop, Ming style main hall, traditional bridal chamber, ebony furniture exhibition hall, mental cultivation in Forbidden City, hall of mental cultivation. The sandalwood is what we're looking at, I guess, right? This is made of sandalwood?
I don't know. We need to ask.
I don't understand why I have it on manual focus and it still tries to...
Tell me that the background of this is sandalwood, but the frame is not.
Mm-hmm.
The character is not.
Right. Okay. This is a quadruple A national level attraction. Look at this, gilded. Is it real gold?
I think maybe.
Dragon and cloud design, huh? Mm.
It looks like very imperial furniture. It's not like common people can
have. Only the emperor can wear imperial yellow. Have you seen that movie?
Which movie?
The Last Emperor.
Yeah, more than twice.
With Peter O'Toole. Do you like it? It's a pretty good movie, actually.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Too sentimental, though.
It's sad.
Yeah.
I think this is too big, you know. The design is huge.
Who's going to move this into their place? It's not going to fit through the door.
It's not feasible.
Totally impractical. I mean...
Impractical.
What are you going to do with it? Put it in a museum. Is it kind of weird to have your greatest work of cabinetry be like completely monstrous and unusable, and it has to be go into a museum because it's so ridiculously large? Look at this big mirror.
I like this mirror.
Imitation throne, Qianqing Palace. Proportion 1:1. Wrapping gold foil reflects imperial supremacy, while the original are gilded pieces.
Is it gold? Or gold foil?
Gold foil? Huh? Said gold foil, but I didn't quite understand the translation. So it says the original are gilded pieces, and this is gold foil, but that's essentially the same, gilding and gold foil. Gilding means a layer of gold on top of something else, usually. Wow. I guess this is too far outside the tourist zone to be in any of the guidebooks. I'm surprised.
It's not on the guidebook?
Nope. Well, that doesn't have so much to do with it as I think how far it is outside of the tourist area. But it's nice to see this because when you go to the Forbidden City, it's so crowded. And I don't remember seeing this at the Forbidden City. If I did, it was so crowded I'd pop my head in maybe over people's shoulders. But I don't remember looking at something like that at all. Here's a tree root carving. Fu Lu Shu standing on ginseng. Fu Lu Shu is three lucky stars in heaven. Happiness, handsome salary, longevity.
Fu Lu Shu.
Huang Hua Li.
Huang Hua Li, Mu Diao. Huang Hua Li is kind of wood we have seen in the Ming Tomb, right?
Ming Tomb?
Yeah. It's built. The Yongle Emperor's tomb.
Ah.
Sort of like build of Mahali wood.
Okay.
You don't remember?
I'm trying to remember that.
I was impressed.
Did you go into that one, or is that where you stayed outside on that one?
I went at one.
So it wasn't the one that was underground? Because they had big red boxes underground that were imitations, I think, of someone's luggage from the afterlife. In the vault. Ding, 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 ding. Red sandalwood cabinet carved in dragon pattern. Imitation of the original in Forbidden City. Forbidden City. The Palace Museum. Dragon in the cloud. In East Asian society, the dragon is god of water, not fire. Resides in the sea. They often pair it in a cloud design, cloud background. A lot of times there's an ascending and a descending dragon together. This is Tiantan. The main altar of agriculture? No. 10,000 Spring Pavilion, Imperial Garden, Forbidden City. West of the Imperial Garden, 10,000 Spring Pavilion, located in the east. So 1,000 Autumn Pavilion located in the west, 10,000 Spring in the east. They echo each other at a distance, symbolizing stability, everlasting state power. Both of the pavilions share the same structure with multi-eaves and pinnacle. The bottom of the pavilion is square, The top is round, which means the heaven is round and the earth is square. Pavilion is made of red sandalwood in proportion of 1 to 5 with adopting Chinese traditional technique of mortise and tenon. Weight of 1,685 kilograms. Concept of a square earth and round heaven. It's the Chinese concept. You see that too at the Shanghai Museum. The atrium square and then the opening at the top is circular, and the whole building shaped like a Shang, Western Zhou Dynasty, Ding, ancient bronze vessel. You can't really see that unless you look at it from above. Screen and throne set carved with images from the painting, figures, and landscape. Five components adopting high relief technique: mountains and rivers, trees, stones, landscape figures carved on it, skilled carving, meticulous polishment, and evident level arrangement made it have very high standard of art. Usually if you want to separate Qing and Ming furniture, it's real easy because Ming... now I'm forgetting. Ming is less ornate, right? And Qing is more ornate because Qing coincided with like the Rococo period. Yeah, 1644. Just start of the Qing. Architectural model of Heavenly Pavilion, located in Wanrong County, Shaanxi Province, initially built in the reign of Emperor Zhengguan in the Tang Dynasty with a height of about 23 meters. Pavilion has three floors and four eaves in appearance, with a secret floor between every two floors, so there are five floors in total. As one of the great rarities among Chinese traditional wooden architecture, this pavilion is famous for magnificent appearance, delicate structure, exquisite design, exhibits made of precious red sandalwood in proportion of 1 to 10 based on Heavenly Pavilion, which has adopted the traditional technique of mortise and tenon. The feature of original pavilion has reappeared. Mortise and tenon is significant because they are letting you know that this is held together without the use of nails. Mortise and tenon is when you slot things together, kind of like building an old-style log cabin, as I understand it. Everything fits inside one another, like a bracket, square-set timber structure with mortise and tenon. Gives it stability, I think, in earthquakes, because there's some rocking that can occur when the vibrations happen, the super high frequency vibrations of an earthquake would cause something built with nails to fall apart, but the mortise and tenon can rock a little bit. There's a furniture gallery in the Shanghai Museum that has some pretty exquisite pieces from Ming and Qing Dynasty. They have a QR code reader on a lot of this, and it looks like an audio guide. Large mirror screen decorated with pattern of five bats supporting the character Shu longevity. You see bats because the symbol for bat sounds like good fortune. So they often pair them together, especially five bat, because what, five is Yi Er San Ch Se. What's five? Yi Er San Chi. Six is. It's five Liu. What's number five? How do you say five? Yi Er San Wu. Wu, Wu. And Wu sounds like good fortune? No. I know it does in Japanese. But the word for bat sounds like good fortune, right? Shui? Yeah? Is that bat? Good. And then the homonym with bat and fortune is what? Fo. Si. No?
Die.
Bats are good because they sound like luck or something.
Yeah, bat is another same pronunciation of fu.
Fu.
Fu, that is happiness.
Happiness, fortune, yeah. And then five sounds like what? That's why they always have five of them, right? Wu is a homonym for something like good? No?
Fu is good.
Okay. In Japanese, five is a homonym for good. That's why people always throw five coins in the shrine or temple. They pray in Japan. Armchair decorated with passion flower carvings, red sandalwood. Ding, 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 ding. It looks too old for your apartment. Little bit. You'd have to hire lots of movers to get this in. Called you mommy?
Yeah, because her mom wearing the same color.
Same color. Five clawed dragon, imperial, pair of armchairs carved with dahlias pattern in red sandalwood. Ding, 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 ding. It's the bed. Cabinet decorated with bamboo and plum pattern. You know why they put bamboo and plum together a lot of the time? Yeah, sometimes you see pine as well. The three friends of winter, pine, bamboo, and plum. Because pine is green through the winter. Bamboo's flexible, doesn't break. And plum blooms in February. Yeah. Canopy bed decorated with pattern of phoenix playing with peony, the king of flowers in China, yeah? Bloom in May, peony. Peony, the big flower. The king of flowers.
Peony, yeah.
Canopy decorated with chi dragon pattern. Huang Hua Li would. I hate it when parents let their kid run wild because they think it's so cute. To them it's cute, to everyone else it's friggin' annoying. Take him to the playground, let him run wild. Bookshelf with flower design and with two drawers, red sandalwood. Wow. This is nice bed.
No.
It's kind of creepy. Yeah, kind of creepy, actually. It's a bit creepy. None of this stuff is lacquered. It looks lacquered, I guess, but it's not lacquered, is it? Mahogany. Canopy bed, Qing style, made of mahogany on the basis of traditional style with little development. On each side of the bed, a door ridge is installed. It applies carving skill of open work to show the motif of hundreds of birds paying respect to Phoenix. It has fine and exquisite craftsmanship and very high level art. May be rated as an art treasure of traditional furniture. The Phoenix.
And the 100 kinds of birds.
Yeah. Boyds. If you want to say, you want to learn to talk with a New York accent?
Uh-huh.
No, you don't. That would be horrible. You should keep your, like, little Britishisms.
In our office, we have one colleague now speaking very strong American accent, and we all...
Make fun of him?
Yeah. He's too strong, you know.
Does he talk like this?
Yeah. Where is your passport?
We have to go park the car. I would get annoyed if someone talked like that. Now we gotta go to this room. We didn't see this. Wow, look at that. Take a picture of that. It's gaudy, though.
Yeah, but it's like magnificent.
It's gaudy.
Is this the co-founder?
You know the word gaudy? It's when something is overdone to the point of being vulgar.
Yeah.
Like
body?
Gaudy, G-A-U-D-Y. Maybe there's an E. Maybe it's G-A-U-D-Y. I think G-A-U-D-E-Y. Gaudy.
Is the words after Gaudi, the Spanish?
Or actually, there's another word that comes from China. The root word is China, and we say chintzy.
Chintzy.
Yeah, when something looks cheap or vulgar because it's overdone and it's shiny and it's got lots of nooks and crannies in it, we say
chintzy.
We say chintzy.
Chintzy.
Meaning cheap Chinese artifact, like.
Chintzy.
Yeah, C-H-I-N-T-Z-Y. Chintzy.
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 Okay.
And another word is a more complex word. I think it might be French. Chinoiserie.
Oh, chinoiserie. I like this one.
You know chinoiserie? You know that word?
I have heard of it, but I can't remember.
That refers to kind of the cheap imitation lacquer stuff that was being pumped out in the...
Chinoiserie.
Late 19th century, early 20th century.
Chinoiserie.
See, what do you call these up at the top here? On the sides of the roof, the end of the roof, the finials.
Finials?
We call it a finial, like the thing that's at the end of the roof tiles there. I think it's a chen, is it? The mythical water bird?
Chen?
Wen? Model of the corner tower. From Forbidden City, mortise and tenon, 6 tons, multi-corners, multi-eaves, various plafonds and roof ridges.
Multi-corner, multi-eaves. Aha, eaves.
There's a plum tree blooming in the picture there. Yeah? Do you know who that lady is?
The founder, I think, of this
museum? Yeah. She is like the wife of a political person or something, no?
We can look the book.
I got it. Here. Ding, 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 ding. Do we do this room? No. It just looks the same. An architectural model of a 1000 autumn pavilion, red sandalwood. This is the other pavilion in Imperial Garden. Opposite.
Yet.
No, we saw the 10,000 spring pavilion. Now this is the autumn. This is the one opposite.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I think they're essentially the same, though.
Yeah, they're essentially the same.
You know this concept of a square earth and round heaven?
Yeah. Oh, you know? Chinese.
See, what is this? You can see it closer here. Is it a dragon?
Which one?
This. The things right
this,
here.
Do you think?
No, up here, this. What is that?
That one looks dragon, like, looks like dragon. This one looks like dragon.
Yeah, but look, it's kind of weird
shape. It's palm. It's palm? It's palm? Jaw? Palm?
I guess. See, in the Qing, the late Qing period, a lot of the style of furniture was being exported. That's where they get the chinoiserie from, the Baroque Rococo style. Massively overdone and overlacquered and... This is mother of pearl inlay with marble. Screen frame with maid's motif. Ebony, 8 components. Central boards, quai. Dragon, turning lines. Lower boards are embossed with bogu patterns. Motif in silk, painted in silk. Look at the detail.
Are they shells?
Yeah, it's mother of pearl, which is the inside of the clam shell.
Yeah, I like this sort of, you know, techniques.
And this one, look, the calligraphy.
Oh, oh my god.
Is mother of pearl. Imagine how painstaking it was to carve that. I wonder if the audio guide's in English. Set of furniture with inlaid mother of pearl. Huai Li wood? Huai Li wood?
Huai Li.
Huai Li. Qing. splayed leg design. Marble. That's that one, I guess. How do you say mama?
Mama?
Yeah. Is that what that kid was saying in English? He was saying the English word?
Same.
I didn't even notice. Altar table, armchair, square table, red sandalwood. An arhat bed carved with bamboo pattern and inlaid with marble mahogany. Three-drawer coffer table with figures landscaped in jichi wood. Show me the way to go home. Tired and I want to go to bed. Pair of armchair carved with passion flower pattern. What do you call a passion flower? Do you know? Xianghua? You know why we call it passion flower in English? Because the flower, I think, looks like Christ being crucified. I think that's what it is. Either the flower or the seed. Passion fruit's kind of a thing now for fruit drink.
Image hanging on the wall.
Yeah.
She is the president of Hong Kong Fuba
International
Group.
An arhat bed.
Huh?
Sorry, go ahead.
Politics.
Politics?
Yeah, politics.
She's a politico?
But it's not CPC.
For Hong Kong, you said.
She has many job titles and now honorable title. One of her job is the president of Hong Kong Fuhua International Group Corporation. And
our hat bed carved with calabash
PhD pad. On humanity.
Okay. Let's see. Calabash pattern symbolizes family with many children. The apron of the bed is carved with chi dragon pattern. I don't know that the calabash is a symbol of a lot of children. Never heard that before. I thought it was a symbol of Eastern traditional medicine. That's what they say at the Museum of Eastern Traditional Medicine in Shanghai. Wow, look at this. Peacock feather. Yeah, it looks like real peacock feathers. Yeah. I would like to be fanned with peacock feathers.
Too fancy.
Screen and throne. Strict requirements for using and displaying the screen and the throne. They only were only reserved for the emperor, empress, and imperial concubines, and displayed in the main hall of the palace or the main room of the bedchamber. They look especially solemn and dignified. Do you think the Empress had her own concubines, either male or female.
Yeah.
She had a harem as well. The Empress. Yeah.
Empress what?
Did the Empress have a harem for herself of men or women? Because the Emperor had one. No, she didn't?
She did. No, she's not allowed to do it.
I would think in reality she probably did.
But there's one exception in Chinese history.
When there was the Empress who was the...
with,
yeah.
You know Wu Zetian?
She was the... there was no emperor. She was the head. Yeah. When, what dynasty was this?
I can't remember his name.
Let's see. Main hall in Qing style. The main hall, key component of Chinese traditional dwelling culture, serves as a place to hold important ceremonies to receive distinguished guests. All the exhibits reflect the typical arrangement of Qing style, which is accurately set with symmetrical layout, complying with etiquette of Confucianism. And the closer you were to the center two chairs there, the higher rank you would be. Lower rank people had to sit further away from whoever was holding court.
You know that.
Yeah, they have a furniture gallery at the Shanghai Museum that said that anyway. There's the bats again, right? Mm. The bats are around a symbol. Yeah?
I cannot see which is the bats.
Are those supposed to be bats?
No.
Flower. Boids. A pair of South styled yoke back armchair, red sandalwood. Yoke back, like the yoke on an ox, I guess. Kind of bumped here where the hump of the neck would fit. If it were a yoke. A lot of people in America have shelves like this.
Yeah, I like simplicity. It's
with
not that complicated design.
With the what we call like a lattice work shelving. Chinese. Imitation Chinese. Multi-treasure display cabinet ebony. This cabinet is made of ebony on the basis of the original piece in the Qing Dynasty, divided in 10 lattices in different heights with 3 drawers at the lower part and decorated with guai zi pattern and design highlights its elegance. What's guai zi mean?
Guai zi. Zetian is the empress in Tang Dynasty. When she take the throne, she was 67.
And she had a harem, right? Mm. I bet.
Of course.
Upstairs. Do you want to go upstairs?
I want to go upstairs.
Tang Dynasty. Take the elevator. That's crazy gold right there.
Mm, it's very gold, gilt gold.
Ding-di-ding-di-ding-ding-ding!
What is that?
That's like classical Chinese ringtone.
Really?
I guess. If you had